Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another awesome video. So let's get cracking. Of course, friends, we're going to start with create new 3D design. So friends, we're going to talk just a little bit about the ruler today. So I'm going to call this Ruler 101. Now, what I saw was a user in the Reddit said, how do I measure things precisely from an exact spot? So friends, if I bring out the ruler and I set it at a spot, notice it tells me that this is 4.82 from this edge. It's not from the point, it's from the edge. I love that I can type 0 here and it snaps. I can type 0 here and boom, it snaps right to that spot. But notice it's not on the point. If I want this on the point, what I can do is shut off the grid, grab the shape, and bring the shape down to that spot. Now it does not snap because I shut off the grid, but you can see I can get it right to that spot. Now I know that it was 7.23 from there. And if I do another one, Control D, and I want to put this exactly, let's say 50 away, I'll type negative 50, and boom, it snaps that way. And say I want the height to be 0, I can type 0. But notice it's from this corner now, and it's measuring to this corner. It's not measuring to the exact spot. So if we wanted to get it so it was lined up with that, we're probably gonna have to do some math to figure out what it is. Or find a new point that would line them up. So check it out. If I take this and move it to that point, and if I change that to 0 now, it snaps down and they are the same height. So I just wanted to show you that you can work from corners and stuff, but you need to shut off that measuring grid so you can get it exactly right. If you do have the measuring grid on, it's nice because you can nudge it with the arrows. If you don't have that grid on, you can measure something from an exact point on your shape. I do want to emphasize it is not showing me the distance here, and there's no way I can adjust that so that it does. One thing you can do is if we switch to midpoint, then it's going from the midpoint of the shape, but these are weird in Tinkercad as well, where this feels like the midpoint of this shape. The actual midpoint is based from here to here. That midpoint does not fit the actual total of the points. It just fits the measurements of X and Y. It does not go from the exact corners. It goes from X and Y. I do want to show you this real quickly too. When this was back up here, the smartest way to get those two to line up would have just been to use a line, click on this one, and say I want it to come down to that bottom edge. I did want to make sure that I've emphasized that you can go from a certain point if you use this off, but I also want to make sure you understood it does not exactly go from the point on the next one, and there are always many ways to solve things in Tinkercad. Friends, as I wrap up, I do want to remind you about my website, hlmodtech.com. I've got a page dedicated to Tinkercad with tons of awesome categories. On the left, you'll also find day one starters. You'll also find some of my favorites and Tinkercad essentials. On the bottom right hand corner, friends, you will find a built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Friends, I do also want to recommend the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, we've got more than 800 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. And of course, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Don't forget, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.